I'm gonna walk through some bonus tips and advice, as well as some shortcuts. Hopefully these tips will help you out with the workflow and efficiency when it comes to animation, as animation can get quite complicated. So right now I have this new file opened up here, and as you can see, I have these multicolored blobs or circles on my canvas, and I'm gonna use these blobs to explain some of the shortcuts and tips. If I play this animation sequence right now, you can see the blobs all kind of move in a different way. They all have different personalities, and if you look in the timeline, they also have different kind of pacing to them. The first thing I'm gonna go through are the layers for this file. It's super important that you separate different elements or moving components of your animation sequence into different layers. So for example, if I had a character walking and a cat flying behind them, it would probably be really useful to separate them into two separate layers, just so that if I need to change the cat or delete the cat, I don't accidentally affect the character that's walking or change something that I don't want to on the character when editing the flying cat behind them. Another is super useful thing when it comes to separating objects into different layers is that you can turn off visibility. So the animation will still run, like this red blob that's jumping, but I can now focus only on the red blob and I don't have to worry about any of the other blobs moving across the screen, as it was getting quite hectic. The other useful thing is that I can unpin other layers. So let's say if I had 20 or I don't know, 30 objects on my timeline, that's way too busy and it gets way too hectic. So having just one pinned onto your timeline can come in really handy when your animation is especially getting really complicated. But if I want to continue working on a layer, I can always just click it on the layer panel and it'll pop back up just like the blue blob right here. And I can now edit it, I can look at its frames, and it won't be pinned onto the timeline. But if I ever want to bring it back, I can always just click the thumbtack icon or right click the layers on the layer panel and click pin to timeline. Now the next thing I'm going to go over are shortcuts. By default, Krita does come with a bunch of shortcuts assigned to different tools, but when it comes to the animation kind of part of it, there aren't any shortcuts assigned at all. In order to get that, we go to settings, configure Krita, and now this window pops up that lets us scroll through a bunch of different categories for us to assign shortcuts to different tools. But we can always just search it up on the search bar up top over here, and I just typed in free because the one tool that I would recommend assigning a shortcut to is freehand selection. So in order to assign a shortcut, we click this drop down arrow and you want to click this box here. I've already personally assigned Shift F to freehand, but you can make it whatever you want. The next thing I would assign shortcuts to, and this is for the animation, is next keyframe, next matching keyframe, play pause, previous keyframe, previous matching keyframe, and onion skin. Now onion skin kind of like an optional one. It really depends on how frequently you use the onion skin and if you tend to toggle it on and off frequently, but it really is up to you. So right now I'm just going to show you the shortcuts kind of in action, just to show you how they work. You can see my mouse is just hovering off to the side, but I can play and pause it whenever I want by pressing Shift V. And if I press Control period and Control comma, I can now jump from frame to frame that has a drawing on it. Now for next matching keyframe, you need to assign a color to it. And to assign a color to a frame, you just right click it and you can select from any of these colors that are on the bottom row. I tend to choose red for my key poses, as those are really the ones that I tend to only color. Every other frame I leave the default blue color. You can join our Patreon, as that will allow you access to special member perks like critiques and classes. Now I color the key poses red because those are really important and it's really useful to flip between them really quickly when you're blocking out your animation sequence, so you can see if everything's flowing properly or if everything is kind of lining up correctly. So you can see that it only jumps to frame 1, 7, and 25. Now another useful trick when you want to only want to play a certain section of your animation sequence is you don't have to actually change the number on the clip start and clip end. You can now click on a frame, hold down Shift and select another section that you want to play. So right now I selected 5 to frame 16, and now because I only have that section highlighted, it will only play that section. So similarly, I can click frame 16, hold down Shift and click frame 25, and it'll only play that section. So just a neat trick when it comes to the playback. You don't need to change it in the animation timeline setting. You can just do that shortcut. Now to toggle on and off the onion skin, you do need to have the light bulb on. So if I click it on, now I can toggle it on and off. And what it's doing is it's turning on and off the big bar in the onion skin kind of panel over there. It's essentially just turning up and down the opacity levels. Another really great trick or shortcut that you can use to ease up your workflow as you're animating is duplicating a keyframe. So I'm gonna use the red blob layer to show you a demonstration as to how this works. I basically wanna duplicate frame 9 and I wanna copy it into frame 24, but I don't wanna right click it and then click duplicate frame. I don't wanna copy it. It takes too much work. So what you can do is hold down control, click and drag it. And you can see now that I've taken frame 9 and placed it into frame 24. So frame 24 now has the exact same drawing as the drawing in frame 9 because I duplicated it. So this is really useful, especially if you creating like looping cycles or if you need a sequence with a lot of frames that you want to duplicate. Because what you can also do is manually select certain frames and also maintain the spacing that those frames have. So I want to duplicate frames 11, 13, and 15, and I want to put them near the end. So I'm going to hold down control and select those three frames, and then I'm going to hold down control, click and drag so that I could put them anywhere I want. And in this case, I'm going to put them at the end of the timeline. So now you can see frame 22, 24, and 26 are the exact same as 11, 13, and 15. Again, this is really useful for looping cycles or if you don't want to redraw something, but you want certain keyframes that you want to move. If you want to learn from me or any of our other professional artists, feel free to check out our website and maybe consider signing up for our classes. You'll get creative assignments, individual guidance, and real-time feedback on your artwork. If you learn something new, please like and share with a fellow art nerd. If you love receiving quality and free arts education, subscribe. And here are a couple other videos you can check out next.